Fan.
Blowers. Play a vital role in the process industries in order to convey the gases or air in the process parameter, required process parameter to achieve the desired reactions. There are two types, one is a centrifugal type and another one is a positive displacement type. Now we are going to see about centrifugal fan and blowers, how to analyze the performance of the individuals. Whenever we are operating the equipment, it is essential for analyzing the performance for energy improvement, cost saving measures, in order to reduce the specific energy consumption for our desired product. For the blowers or the fan, we can rotate with the help of electric motors or turbines. In this video, we will see about the turbine driven air blower performance. It is a very simple method. It will be the 4 minutes to calculate the efficiency, and we can identify the where is the lag, how we can improve the performance and cost saving measures where we can take. Now it is a typical turbo blower. This is a turbine. There will be the gearbox for the transmission. Whether it will be the speed reduction or speed up. Normally speed reduction will be there because turbine will run normally at the higher RPM. Blower will not require that much speed. So with the help of gearbox, we will reduce the RPM. By reducing the RPM, definitely we will get the increase in the torque. So in the blower, we know that there will be the impeller. Multiple types are there. Axial, radial, propeller type impellers. And then the casing. Suction will have the filter because it is the air blower. We are taking the ambient air as a suction, so we have the filter in this blower, suction filters, filter pads. Discharge, we have the silencer in order to reduce the noise. We want to maintain the pollution control board norms. Further, we have the silencer. So normally, how it will operate? So with the help of the turbine, we will get the rotational mechanical energy input to the blower. So the impeller will get rotate. So due to the rotation, air will be sucked through the eye of the impeller. Due to the rotation, there is a negative pressure creation will be there. So due to the negative pressure, ambient pressure is 1 bar and this negative pressure, definitely air will get conveyed to the eye of the impeller and then it will stick into the casing. So as we seen in the centrifugal pump, same philosophy will be taken part. So this air will get compressed and velocity will get increase, and then this velocity energy will be converted into the pressure energy and then conveyed to the discharge. So for this performance analysis, what we need, what is the input power to the shaft for the blower, and what is the output power, the energy stored in the discharge. So this is the mechanical energy input, and we get the output in the form of compressed air. So we'll go to the calculation part. What are the requirements? So now we consider the turbine. So first we'll find out the turbine power. If it is a motor driven, already we in the previous videos we calculate the both the powers, turbine output power and motor power, both we have calculation video, we can go through it. Now in a short span I'm explaining turbine power, how we want to calculate. We are considering it is the isentropic process in the turbine. So steam inlet temperature, inlet pressure, and extraction, it is extraction type turbine, or condensing also we can. But it is condensing also, it will be the same formula. So temperature in the outlet, steam outlet, and outlet pressure, both we want to find out with the help of steam table, what is the enthalpy in the inlet steam, enthalpy of the extraction steam, and isentropic enthalpy. Whenever the turbine is operating in isentropic condition, we will achieve this enthalpy, but it is not isentropic condition is achieved in the turbine. So our energy enthalpy output is 3200 and isentropic enthalpy is 2700. We want to compare this with the isentropic condition, so we'll get the efficiency, isentropic efficiency. So isentropic enthalpy also we need the steam table. Previously we in the turbine efficiency, turbine performance analysis, we calculate the those things. This is how to calculate from the steam table, so we can go through it. And mass flow rate to the turbine, we have the mass flow meter in the inlet of the turbine, steam inlet, so by that we can measure this one. And blowout side, suction side pressure minus 0.025, because we are sucking air from the ambient, so definitely it will be negative pressure, and discharge is 0.65 bar cage. And our volumetric flow rate in the discharge is 159 kilometer cube per hour. That is, it will become 159,000. It will be there. So we are going for calculation part. So power developed by the turbine, that is simple. What is the energy in the inlet of the steam? That is 3212.86. 3212.86 minus enthalpy at the extraction 2792.48. So this is in kilo joule per kg. So this is a kilojoule per kg. 1 kg of steam, energy loss is this much. That is power taken, power delivered by the turbine into mass flow rate of the steam is 34 metric ton per hour. 34 metric ton, it is in kg, so it is in metric ton, so we are multiplying by the 1000. So it will give, so this is in unit, is unit will be kilo joule per kg into kg per hour. We got it. So kilo joule per hour will be the final. We need to convert the hour into second, so we want to divide it by 3600. So we got it kilojoule per second. So kilojoule per second, it will be kilowatt. It is in the kilowatt right now. So 3970 kilowatt is the steam energy lost in the turbine. So we taken this one. Is isentropic efficiency
if you want to call, you can call it, but in this blower efficiency, it is not rocket, power only they required. So 3212.86 minus 3212.86 minus 2792.48, it is the energy in the output. So you want to consider it to the isentropic, right? So this divided by inlet steam energy and isentropic enthalpy is 2630, right? 2630. So this is our isentropic efficiency of the turbine. So blower output power you want to calculate. It is a simple formula. That is what we calculate in the centrifugal pump, same that flow rate into power developed, sorry, head developed, that is the output power. So air flow rate is 159 kilometer cube per hour, right? 159 into 1000 for converting meter cube per hour. So we want to convert into second, so 3600, correct? So 159 into 1000, so meter cube per second we got it, into pressure developed, right? So discharge pressure is, we got it, do I say how much, 0.65 bar and suction is 0.025 bar. 0.65 minus of minus 0.025 bar. So it is in bar, right? We need newton per meter square, right? So 1 bar is equal to 101325 newton per meter square. Okay, you got it now. So what is the unit in this here? Meter cube per hour, meter cube per hour, sorry, we converted a second, right? Meter cube per second into newton per meter square. By unit conversion you can easily cross check it. So now it will came newton meter per second, meter square and meter cube will get cancelled and newton meter per second will be there. So newton meter per second is what? Newton meter is joule, joule per second is what? That's it, right? So divided by 1000, if we multiply, it will give in kilowatt. So this is the blower output power, it is in kilowatt. Okay, so now what do you want to do? 3021 is the blower output power, that is energy stored in the air. Output by input is the efficiency. Now we are calculating mechanical efficiency, simple. So output is this one, input is this one, into 100, that is 3021 divided by 3970, right? It is power developed by the turbine, it is going to blower. One more thing we missed in this gearbox efficiency, you can take it. So if you take gearbox efficiency will be 99% if we take. So in this 99 will be go to the 0.01% will be the loss in the gearbox. So we want to minus it. So 0.9 we put into 100, you will get the efficiency of blower. That is 76.86 is the your mechanical efficiency of the blower. 77% for this, it is quite okay. It is not underperformed. So if it is lower than 75 or 70, we want to look into it because it is a higher capacity blower in this. So it should don't go down below this. So what are the parameters will affect the blower performance? We will see in the next video. Thank you so much. Now quite, we'll go for quick recap. So blower, what is in the air blower and fan and blower, efficiency calculation will be the same. Mechanical efficiency calculation will be the same. So you can utilize this one. Blower will convey the or pressurize the air for gas for our requirement, process requirement. What are the parameters required? Turbine. If you take this turbine, so we want to consider this thing parts or motor, you can get the motor shaft power, that is motor output power. It can use it for the efficiency part. So calculation part, power delivered by the turbine, we calculated by difference minusing the enthalpy into steam flow rate, and then blower output power we calculated by flow rate into power pressure developed. So gearbox efficiency we taken as 10% efficient, so 0.01 is be the loss, so we subtracted in the 0.9 only we taken, it is the input power into 0.9, output power is 0.021, so both are in kilowatt, so kilowatt divided by kilowatt it will be cancelled, so we got this 77% efficient.